In this video, we're going to talk more about Z-scores, and I'm going to show you how to use a special table that will help you to find out more information about data that is normally distributed. In this example, students in an Algebra 2 class took a test on probability. After grading the test, the teacher announces that the test scores are normally distributed with a mean of 78 and a standard deviation of 8. The test was out of 100 points with the opportunity to earn some extra credit points. We're going to use this information to answer the following questions. Since we know that the data is normally distributed, I've already drawn the bell-shaped curve that we know represents any normal distribution. Remember, whenever you find out that data is normally distributed, you should feel comfortable drawing this bell-shaped symmetric unimodal curve to represent the data. Let's label the normal curve with the information that we've been given. We know that the mean is 78, and whenever we have a normal distribution, the mean is exactly in the center. So I'm going to label the center tick mark with 78. We also know that the standard deviation is 8. In previous videos, we learned that the space between each tick mark represents one standard deviation. So I'm going to add the standard deviation of 8 to label my tick marks to the right of 78, and I'm going to subtract the standard deviation of 8 to label my tick marks to the left of 78. 78 plus 8 gives me 86, which is one standard deviation above the mean. 86 plus 8 gives me 94, which is two standard deviations above the mean. And 94 plus 8 gives me 102, which is three standard deviations above the mean. Now I'm going to subtract 8 to label my tick marks to the left. 78 minus 8 gives me 70, which is one standard deviation below the mean. 70 minus 8 gives me 62, which is two standard deviations below the mean. And 62 minus 8 gives me 54, which is three standard deviations below the mean. Now let's take a look at our questions. The first question asks, what percentage of students scored above an 86? We know that 86 is exactly one standard deviation above the mean, and we're looking for the percentage under the curve to the right of 86. Well, this reminds me of the 68, 95, 99.7 rule. That rule told me that 68% of the data is within one standard deviation of the mean, 95% of the data is within two standard deviations of the mean, and 99.7% of the data is within three standard deviations of the mean. Now these percentages by themselves still don't really tell us the percentage to the right of 86. But in the video I made about the 68, 95, 99.7 rule, I showed you how you can determine the percentages in each section of the table using this rule. I'm not going to go over how to find these percentages again. I'm just going to label them on the curve because you can use them for any normal curve. You don't have to recalculate them each time. So we found that there were 34% of the data in each of these middle sections. We found that the next outer sections each have 13.5% of the data. We found that the next outer sections each have 2.35% of the data. And we found that the very small outer sections on the ends each have 0.15% of the data. So remember, you don't have to recalculate these every time you have a normal distribution because these apply to any normal curve you have. So now to find the percentage of students that scored above an 86, we can add up the percentages to the right of 86. So I'm going to add 13.5 plus 2.35 plus 0.15. That gives me 16% of students that scored above an 86. The next question asks, what percentage of students scored below a 62? So for this one, I'm looking for the percentages to the left of 62, which is exactly two standard deviations below the mean. So in my calculator, I'm going to add 2.35 plus 0.15, and that gives me 2.5% of students that scored below a 62. The next question asks, what percentage of students scored between a 62 and 86? So for this one, I need to add up the percentages between 62 and 86. That's 13.5 plus 34 plus 34. That gives me 81.5% of students that scored between a 62 and an 86. The next question asks, what percentage of students scored below a 60? This question is a little different because 60 isn't already labeled on our curve. Now we can figure out around where 60 would be. It would be between 54 and 62. And we're looking for the percentage of students that scored below a 60. So we're looking for the percentage of data under the curve in this section to the left of 60. Now, in order to do this, we can't just add up the percentages we already have labeled because we don't know since it's not on an exact tick mark. What we're going to do is we're going to find the z-score for 60, and then we're going to use a z-score table to find out the exact percentage to the left of 60. Now, if you remember from the last video, z-scores tell us the number of standard deviations above or below the mean a data point is. We know that, for example, 62 is 2 standard deviations below the mean, so the z-score for 62 is -2, and 54 is 3 standard deviations below the mean, so the z-score for 54 is -3. So we know the z-score for 60 must be between -2 and -3. Luckily, we have a formula to tell us exactly the z-score for 60. So let's plug 60 into our formula. So z equals 60 minus the mean, which is 78, divided by the standard deviation, which is 8. So I'm going to do 60 minus 78 and then divide by 8, which gives me -2.25. So that tells me that 60 is 2.25 standard deviations below the mean. Now we're going to use the z-score table to find out the percentage to the left of 60. So to get this z-score table, you can go to z-table.com, and it will take you to this z-score table. It's a lot of numbers, and obviously you don't need to memorize it, but it is just a resource that you should feel comfortable using. In this table, it gives us the area to the left of any z-score on a normal curve. Now, as you can see, the difference here is that the area is given as a decimal, so all we will have to do is convert that decimal to a percentage by multiplying by 100. And remember, this only gives us the area to the left. So that's what we're looking for anyway. In this question, we're looking for the percentage below 60. So I just need to find my z-score in the table. Since I have a negative z-score, I'm going to use the table on the top. And on the left, it gives me my z-score up to the tenths place. And across the top, it gives me the hundredths place. So I just need to match up what I'm looking for. Since my z-score is -2.25, I need to start by finding -2.2 on the left, which I see is right here. Then I need to find 0.05 at the top because my hundredths place is 5 in -2.25. Then I just need to find where they line up, what number do they line up to in the table, and that is 0.0122. So I'm going to go back to where I was working and write down 0.0122 as the area under the curve to the left. So now all I have to do is convert this to a percentage by multiplying by 100, or moving my decimal 2 to the right, and that gives me 1.22% of students that scored below a 60, which makes sense because it's a very small area. So it's a very small percentage. Let's try this again using the z-score table. The next question asks what percentage of students scored above a 90. Once again, 90 is not already labeled. 90 would be between 86 and 94. And we already know the z-score for 86 is 1 because it's 1 standard deviation above the mean, and the z-score for 94 is 2 because it's 2 standard deviations above the mean. So I know my z-score for 90 will be between 1 and 2 when I plug it into the formula. So z equals 90 minus 78 divided by 8. So in my calculator, I'll do 90 minus 78, then divide by 8, and that gives me 1.5. And I know that in my table, I'm going to need to know the hundredths place, so I want to remember that there's an invisible 0 after the 5. So now I need to go to my table, find 1.50, and see what area it gives me. Remember, it's going to give me the area to the left, and I'm going to want the area to the right. So I'll show you how we can use the area to the left to find the area to the right, because we're looking for students that scored above a 90. So if I go to my table, I'm going to go to the one with the positive z-scores, which is down here at the bottom. I'm going to start by looking for up to my tenths place on the left. So I'm going to look for 1.5 on the left, which is right here. And then I need the 0.00, which is that first column on the left. Up here it said 0.00. You can't see it right now. And then if I come down, I see that it gives me the area 0.9332. So I'm going to go back to my work and write down the number I found, which is 0.9332. Now remember, the table always gives us the area to the left. So that just gave me this whole area to the left of 90, which is a very big percentage. I'm looking for the area to the right of 90 because I want to know the percentage of students that scored above a 90. Well, Currently, this is giving me 93.32%. And to find the percentage above 90, I'm just going to take that percentage and subtract it from 100 because I know that overall my curve has a total of 100% of the data. So if I take 100 and subtract 93.32, that will give me the percentage to the right of 90, which will make more sense because we should have a smaller percentage that's above 90. That gives me 6.68% of students that scored above a 90. So always remember that the table gives you the area to the left, and you need to make sure you use that correctly to find the area you're being asked for in the question.